At the center of the Milky Way galaxy is a supermassive black hole. And just like how in the solar system, the Earth and all the other planets orbit the sun in the center, the sun and all the 100 billion other stars of the Milky Way orbit the black hole in the center. But what would happen if, hypothetically speaking, we could remove the black hole from the center of the Milky Way? If we could just, and it would disappear. Now, you're probably expecting me to decry that chaos would ensue and that we'd all be doomed, but that is not what would happen at all. In fact, the galaxy would barely even notice if the black hole in the center disappeared. Intrigued? Confused? Keep watching to find out why. Now, I am a sucker for a good hypothetical science question, and especially this one, A, because it's about my favourite topic, black holes, but also because the answer is so unexpected that, you know, nothing would really happen if you were to remove the black hole from the centre. Instead, I guess what you would expect is the chaos that would ensue if, for example, you were to remove the sun from the centre of the solar system. The planets and asteroids and comets and all the other detritus of the solar system, you know, wouldn't have anything, you know, gravitationally holding them in their orbits anymore. It'd be like releasing a load of like discus or hammer throws at once, right? They'd all just fly off in whatever direction they've been going in at whatever speed as well they've been going at, and it'd all disperse. But that's not what would happen to the hundreds of billions of stars in the Milky Way if you were to remove the thing that they're orbiting around, the black hole at the center. And it's all to do with the fraction of mass of the black hole compared to the rest of the galaxy. So in the solar system, if we were to add up the total mass of all the stuff in the solar system and compare that to the mass of the thing they're orbiting around, the sun, we find that the sun is 99.86% of all the stuff in the solar system. So Jupiter, Saturn, Earth, etc., all the asteroids, comets, they only make up 0.14% of all of the mass in the solar system, and Jupiter is the majority of that. So if you were to remove the sun, you'd remove the majority of the mass in that system. You'd literally be removing the anchor that holds everything into place. But if I were to do the same with the Milky Way galaxy, and I were to add up the mass of all of the stars in the Milky Way galaxy, maybe even the dust and the gas as well, and compare that to the mass of the black hole in the center, get a very different answer. We find that the black hole in the center is 4 million times the mass of the sun, whereas the entire galaxy is more like 60 billion times the mass of the sun, meaning that the supermassive black hole, although supermassive, is still only 0.01% of the total mass in stars of the galaxy. So it's a tiny fraction, and so the impact won't be as great if we could just oof and remove the black hole from the center of the galaxy. Having said that, the stars that orbit really close to the black hole, right in the very center of the galaxy, the ones that we've been studying for decades, tracing out their orbits and using that to actually measure the mass of the black hole at the center and work out that it's 4 million times bigger than the sun, those are the ones that probably would actually feel an impact. Yes, they probably would just fly off in whatever direction they were going in their orbit at whatever speed as soon as the black hole disappeared and, you know, just dispersed. Just like we spoke about before, saying, you know, if you could remove the sun from the center of the solar system, the planets would all fly off and disperse as well. But the majority of the stars in the Milky Way wouldn't even notice a thing. The galaxy would just keep on spinning. And that's because of something we call self-gravity. Yes, it's made up of individual stars that are at these great, great distances, along with, you know, gas and dust and dark matter and everything. But the sheer scale of it means that it acts like a single system. In the same way that if we removed a big chunk of the Earth, for example, like, you know, what would all the atoms do that make up the Earth? Which, you know, atoms are very, very tiny, but comparison to their size, they're really spread out. But if you just took out this tiny little fraction of the Earth, this tiny chunk of 0.01%, the Earth would be fine, right? It has its own self-gravity holding it together. And it's the same for the Milky Way. The self-gravity of the 60 billion times the mass of the sun, mass of all the stars, would hold it together. And you might be thinking, well, what about galaxies that have more massive black holes that aren't a million times the mass of the sun, but a billion times the mass of the sun. Surely that's going to be a sizable fraction compared to the galaxy. For example, like in Messier 87, right? This is the galaxy that we've took an image of the supermassive black hole in the center of with the Event Horizon Telescope. And with that image, we were able to work out that the mass of the black hole is 6.5 billion times the mass of the sun. That's over 1,000 times bigger than the Milky Way's black hole. And you'd think, well, removing that from the galaxy would have a much bigger impact, surely. But no, because Messier 87, the galaxy that it lives in, is also much more massive. It has so many more stars than the Milky Way, you know, into the trillions. And this is something we see for all galaxies across the universe, that the total mass in stars in a galaxy correlates with the supermassive black hole mass. And as the galaxy grows, so too does the black hole. So this is something we call co-evolution, the galaxy and the black hole growing and evolving together over cosmic time in the universe. And what it means is essentially that the supermassive black hole will always be somewhere in the range of about 0.01% up to about 1% of the stellar mass of the galaxy, the mass in stars. And that's just because of, you know, scatter around that correlation. And this is what I do my research on, you know, I look into the processes that are responsible for this simultaneous growth of galaxies and black holes. So it's quite close to my heart. So it's so cool to think that this graph that I pretty much stare at nearly every single day of my life is the reason why, if you could just make a black hole in the center of a galaxy disappear, the galaxy of billions, if not trillions of stars, wouldn't feel a single thing. Before we get to the bloopers, which I know is everyone's favorite part, I just want to say a huge thank you to this week's video sponsor, KiwiCo. KiwiCo make these subscription crates that have these hands-on projects and toys that are designed to introduce kids to concepts in science and maths and technology. Each monthly crate is tailored to a specific age range, from the littlest kids to the biggest kids. For example, this is one of their 5+ crates, all about the solar system. And it comes with all the supplies you'll need, so there's no last minute dashes to the shops. This box, however, is from their 9+ Tinker Crate range. And it's all about rockets and chemistry, introducing kids to the concept of thrust, but also to the chemistry of gases like carbon dioxide in fizzy drinks, and how you can generate carbon dioxide with a bit of baking soda, some citric acid, and water. This was honestly so much fun. I class as 9+, right? So if there's a little kid or a big kid like me in your life that you know would love a subscription like this, then head to kiwico.com/DrBecky50 for 50% off your first month of any subscription crate. Or you can click on the link in the video description below. Big thanks to KiwiCo for continuing to support this channel and for getting kids excited about science as well. We love that here. But now, roll those bloopers. I am on the struggle bus today. I feel like I've come back from my holiday and I just need another holiday. In my view, black hole's gonna do nothing. And I believe that gravity will hold in place. That means that the supermassive black hole is only 0.01%. Oh, hang on, last time I said no, the Americans were all like, no, what was that? That means that the supermassive black hole in the center of the Milky Way is only 0.01. It just sounds weird. I'm sorry. I'm sticking to naught.